Your use of alcohol has gotten you into a lot of trouble. Obviously, alcohol and guns don't mix. That's gotten you where you are today. But where you go from today, how you handle the rest of your life, it's entirely in your hands, and you're going to choose your own path. We can all hope that you choose the right path. And you're going to pay the penalty for what you did. But thereafter, there's days going to come that you're going to be out of jail, and you're going to be on the street, and you're going to decide what you're going to do. Hopefully, you can get the counseling you need that'll help you find your way. And I am satisfied that you have expressed your regrets and your remorse for the harm that you caused. I've seen that over and over in the letters. I've seen it in the letters even from Sal DeFazio about apparently visiting the grave on more than one occasion. Also, that you have no prior indictable convictions. With regard to the maximum term imposed on those third-degree crimes that counsel talked about, I do find that with regard to the aggravating mitigating factors that the maximum term of 5 years is appropriate in weighing the factors, but also in taking into consideration the plea agreement that was reached in order to reach a resolution. So with regard to these matters, on the charge of hindering apprehension, which is a third-degree crime, on the charge of tampering with witnesses, which is also a third-degree crime, on each of those matters, it will be a 5-year term in state prison. On the fourth-degree count of aggravated assault, and given the fact that this is a Graves Act violation, which has been stipulated to and agreed upon by all counsel that this does qualify under the Graves Act, it will be an 18-month term, 18 months to be served without parole. On the charges of tampering with evidence, fabricating evidence, both fourth-degree charges, those also will be 18-month terms. The counts will all run concurrent to each other, so it's a net aggregate term of 5 years in state prison, 18 months to be served without parole. Good luck to you, Mr. Williams.